Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Pokémon Yellow for the Game Boy. In our last episode, we started our adventures on Cinnabar Island, and first we visited the Pokémon Lab and managed to revive some fossilized Pokémon into living specimens, and then we explored the Pokémon Mansion, a Pokémon lab that was destroyed by a mysterious experimental Pokémon, and we were able to find the secret key, an item that will allow us to enter the Cinnabar City Pokémon Gym to fight Blaine, that will allow us to claim our 7th badge, and that is just what we are going to do in this episode. But before we get to that, you know what time it is. Pokedex progress. Out of 145 Pokemon that we've seen, we own 143, which means that out of the full 151 Pokemon that can be found in a full Pokedex, we are just 8, count them, 8 Pokemon away from having a full Pokedex. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are getting in more ways than one, we are getting very close to finishing off this Let's Play. We are very close to the end of the game in more ways than one. I'm telling you that right now. In fact, I'm going to show you guys some of the Pokemon that I've got. I did a lot of things to try and get some of these Pokemon, but let me show some of them off to you. First of all, I returned to the Safari Zone, and I was finally able to catch Scyther and Pinsir. These are the two rare bug-type Pokémon that, unless you play a certain version and can go to the game corner, these two Pokémon, Scyther and Pinsir, can only be found in the Safari Zone, and I was finally able to get my hands on them. Also, you may remember in the last episode, I managed to revive Ammonite and Kabuto, as well as Aerodactyl from Pokemon Fossils. Well, at least I was able to revive Kabuto and Aerodactyl. I got Ammonite from a trade. And I did some grinding work with them off-screen, and I managed to get them to evolve into their evolved form. Amistar, the evolved form of Ammonite, and Kabutops, the evolved form of Kabuto. And if I may say something right now, Kabutops is one of the most awesome Pokemon in Generation 1. I love Kabutops' design. I just love that thing. It just looks awesome. And here at the bottom, I have two rare Pokemon that cannot be caught in Yellow version. You want to get these two Pokemon, you have to go with Red and Blue version. First we have Electabuzz. Electabuzz is an electric type Pokemon that can only be found in the power plant, and even then it can only be found in the power plant in Red version. You cannot find it in Yellow version or Blue version. You have to catch it in Red version, and I was able to do that. And over here we have Magmar, a rare fire-type Pokémon that can only be found in Blue version at the Pokémon Mansion on Cinnabar Island. And sort of an interesting thing to note about this Magmar, it's kind of there's a bit of a story behind this Magmar to sort of explain why it's at such a high level compared to all the other Pokémon. This Magmar, I have quite a history with this particular Magmar. This Magmar is not from my Blue version. It is actually an old Magmar from my Pokemon Gold version, one of the second generation games. That is where this Magmar actually originated from. And it was a Magmar that I had stored in Pokemon Stadium for the N64, and then I ended up storing it in Blue version for a long time. So, to give a little bit of a history from this Magmar. So, it's from Blue version, but it's not really from Blue version. I didn't originally catch it in Blue version. but I had it stored in blue version and I traded it to Pokemon Yellow from Pokemon Blue. Okay. So now it's time to move on. There is one more Pokemon I do want to show off. I just have to get in the Pokemon box from the PC to show it off. Let's deposit all these Pokemon. Okay, now it's time to show off one last Pokemon. This thing. This is Ditto, a very unique and rare normal type Pokemon. If you're playing Yellow version, the only place you can find Ditto is at the bottom floor of the Pokemon Mansion on Cinnabar Island. What makes Ditto a unique Pokemon is that it knows only one move. It only knows one move known as Transform. And when you use Transform in battle, Ditto will... Well, the name is obvious. Ditto will transform into a near exact copy of its opponent. So let's say it's facing a Charizard and it uses Transform. Ditto will transform into a Charizard. And it will copy its opponent's attacks and its stats, except for HP. It'll copy every stat except for HP, and it'll copy all of the Pokemon's abilities and attacks. So that's Ditto. But now it's time to bring back, it's time to once again put the real team back together. Because now, my friends, it's time to take on Blaine in the Pokémon Gym. It's time to get our 7th badge. And then after that, Cinnabar Island will be completely done. Oh. Where you think you're going, Magmar? You're not going with us. And Pikachu's happy that I took him out of the box. Like, Pikachu does not like it if you put him in the Pokemon box. Although he seems to be happy that I let him out. Okay. My lineup is set. Take a look at Dugtrio, because I'm going to be using him a little bit in this gym. And it's time, my friends. It's time to go to the gym. Alright, tell me something about this place. Yo, champion making! The hot-headed Blaine is a fire Pokemon pro. Douse his spirits with water. You better take some burn heals. I think I'll be fine. Now here's an interesting thing. You saw me just now walk in front of the trainer. He didn't challenge me to a fight, because there's actually a way to avoid a trainer battle in this gym. You go up to these machines, and when you go to a machine and press A, you'll activate what's called a Pokemon quiz. Get it right, and the door opens to the next room. Get it wrong, and face the trainer blocking the way. If you want to conserve your Pokemon for the gym leader, then get it right. Here we go! Caterpie evolves into Butterfree. Is this a trick question? I don't know whether to say yes or no, because some of these questions can actually trick you up a little bit, because it says evolves into Butterfree. Of course it evolves into Butterfree. But I don't know what I'm saying. Let's just answer it. Okay, it was yes. You're absolutely correct. Go on through. So now that I've answered the question correctly, I can actually skip this guy. But I'm not going to. I was a thief, but I became straight as a trainer. Well, good to know you turned your life around. Now you're gonna get your ass kicked. Burglar. Ah, Growlithe. Like, when I was talking about that question kind of tripping me up was it trying to ask if Caterpie directly evolves into Butterfree? Or did it mean evolves into Butterfree as in Butterfree is Caterpie's final stage of evolution after a Metapod? Like, if someone doesn't quite think about that question, they might actually answer it wrong. And my phone just got a message. A message that was not important. Like, if, like, the reason I'm pointing that out is you probably heard it. Like, the microphone probably picked up my phone vibrating. Because, I mean, these little phones, I got a little Samsung Galaxy S, and these phones, man, I don't know what device they have that makes it vibrate, but it's a pretty powerful little device. Like, you can really hear it vibrate, depending on where you've got the phone. Like, if you have it sitting on a piece of wood or something, like a desk, it'll be really loud and noticeable. Alright, Ninetales. Let's stick with Dugtrio. I'm gonna try to use Slash from now on. I don't want to waste Dig, we might actually need it. And will this be enough? Yes, it is enough! Wow, that one was the critical hit, not Slash. That's funny. That's funny. I surrender! Yeah, I bet you. Yeah, you surrender your money too. Give me some of that moolah. Uh-oh. One for each trainer in the same room. Pick your poison. Pokémon quiz, test your skill. There are 9 certified Pokémon League badges. I'm gonna have to say no to that one. Unless there's some secret badge that I don't know about. But that would be highly unlikely, considering I've been playing this game for, you know, 14. I've been playing this game for 14 years. There are very few things about this game that actually surprise me anymore. Do you know how hot fire Pokémon breath can get? No, and I don't want to find out. Like, there are a few things about the old Pokémon games that really surprise me anymore, but still, even after all these years of playing them, I love being able to, you know, go back and play through them again. Just, you know, I love just going through them. I love these old games. And I really have been enjoying this Let's Play, even though we're still not done yet. Like, folks, it's real. Those of you that are following this and watching this LP and supporting me and this channel as a whole, it really has been a pleasure putting together this LP. But anyway, Dugtrio has leveled up and it's time to learn a new move, Earthquake. Earthquake is the most powerful ground type move. Well, actually, there is one move that's more powerful, but it has a drawback to it. Okay, it's somebody else's turn. I'm not letting Dugtrio hog all the glory, are you nuts? And down you go. Ninetales. Alright, you shouldn't be a problem. Yow! Hot, hot, hot! I don't see how that would be hot. I mean, I was using water. Okay. Gyarados, you take the front. Okay, time to beat this guy. You can't win. I have studied Pokémon totally. Oh yeah? Let's see how much good that knowledge does. Put it to use. Ponyta. Yeah, funny story. Earlier today, I was actually grinding before I started recording this thing, and I was leveling up Kabuto to make a Kabutops, and I was fighting a wild Ponyta, and Kabuto actually got burned off of a fire attack from a Ponyta. I actually posted a Facebook status about it on my Facebook page for this channel, and I was like, how can a rock and water type Pokemon with a dual resistance to fire, how can that get burned? That doesn't make any sense. Ah, Charmander. I didn't mean to use Dragon Rage. I meant to use Bubble Beam. Might as well finish it off. And that's what you get for not making your Charmander evolve. It's still weak. Vulpix. Yeah, pretty much gonna be the same few Pokemon here. Like, that's kind of the problem with a Pokemon, with a gym that follows a specific theme, which all the gyms do. Eventually, you're gonna find out that there isn't really that much variety of Pokemon. At least in Generation 1. In later generations, some of the gyms do try to mix it up a little bit, but not by much. And goodbye. Wah! My studies! Yeah, they didn't do you too much good, did they? Okay, next room. Well, we got a whole bunch more to go. We have a lot more rooms to get through. Pokemon quiz, test your skill. Poliwag evolves 3 times. No. You're absolutely correct. Go on through. Well, you could say he evolves 3 times, just not consecutively. I mean, in Generation 2, he got another evolved form called Politoed, but Politoed branches off from Poliwhirl, so I don't know where I'm going with that. I'm just gonna shut up and keep going. I just like using fire Pokemon. Oh, so you're a pyromaniac. Only one, huh? It better be a good one. And it's not. Level 41, that's a pretty high level, but still. Alright. Too hot to handle. You bring along more than just one Pokemon, dude. Next quiz. Are Thunder moves effective against ground element type Pokemon? No. Everyone should know that. Unless you're talking about the anime, which got it wrong. I know why Blaine became a trainer. And you're not gonna tell me, huh? What is it? Is it a personal thing between the two of you? Oh, Rapidash. Rapidash, this is a Pokemon we actually haven't seen yet. Rapidash is the evolved form of Ponyta. And oh, so close. Wow, that's your big move, huh? Tail Whip. You suck. And Gyarados levels up. Ow! Yeah. And you still haven't told me why Blaine became a trainer. You trying to keep something from me? Alright. Let's give Charizard a chance. Pokemon quiz, yada yada yada. Pokémon of the same kind and level are not identical. Yes. Because their stats could be different. Like one could have higher speed than the other. That's a pretty that one could be pretty obscure. Because, you know, that's not something that a lot of people will immediately realize. But just because two Pokemon are the same type and same level, like let's say, I can't believe I'm going into a detailed explanation of this. But you know, think of it like this. Let's say I have two Charizards. They're both at level 47. One could have a higher defense stat than the other, and one could have a lower special stat than the other. Something like that. But anyway, it's time to fight another trainer. I've been to many gyms, but this is my favorite. I got nothing to say. He likes this gym the best. He likes this gym the best. Who am I to criticize? Yeah, do quick attack. That's all you can do, because you're gonna die. Growlithe. Okay. I can dig it. Alright. Next! Next victim! Yowza! Too hot! Yeah, and this time that was actually appropriate, because I was actually using a fire type. Okay, this should be the last room before Blaine. TM28 contains Tombstoner. No. There is no such move. What is TM28? I forget. I've actually forgotten. Fire is weak against H2O. Well, thanks for the chemistry lesson. Okay. Another Growlithe, huh? This should be easy. And I just looked up TM28. I got my little guidebook right next to me. TM28 is Dig. Figured it was a ground type move, but I couldn't quite remember. I wanted to say Earthquake, but Earthquake is TM26. Oh, snuffed out! Yes, you were. And your gym leader is next. How do you like the sound of that? Okay, here we go. It's Blaine time. And, going with Gyarados, baby. Alright, let's do this. Ha! I am Blaine. I am the leader of Cinnabar Gym. My fiery Pokemon will incinerate all challengers. Ha! You better have Burn Heal! Huh. Yeah? Well, you better hope you can somehow take care of my Pokemon that are strong against your type. Alright, here we go. It's time for Blaine. Who looks like a complete lunatic. Like, seriously, the sprite for Blaine looks like a crazy person. Alright, we got a Ninetales, level 48. Oh, so close. That shouldn't do too whoa! Ah, critical hit. Unfortunately for you, say goodbye. Rapidash. Let's bring out Alakazam. Let's make this interesting. Level 50. Wow. And booyah! Critical hit, down you go! How do you like that, Blaine? Alright, last Pokemon. Arcanine. Alright, this is it. This should end it. Come on, come on. Yes! Critical hit, it probably wasn't even needed. I have burnt out. You have earned the Thunder Badge. I mean, why did I say Oh God. Volcano Badge. Oh my God. Why did I say Thunder? Oh God, I just ruined the moment. That totally just ruined the moment. I should just restart the whole damn recording right there. Oh my God. Anyway, we got the Volcano Badge. God, I'm an idiot. Anyway, ha! The Volcano Badge heightens the special abilities of your Pokémon. Here, you can have this too! TM38. TM38 contains Fire Blast. Teach it to Fire-type Pokémon. Charmeleon or Ponyta would be good bets. How about I teach it to no one? Fire Blast is a good move, it's the most powerful fire-type move in the game, but it has a bit of a problem with accuracy. Alright. Cinnabar Island Pokémon Gym Leader Blaine, winning trainers Travis, Matt. Okay, and that, my friends, is 7 badges down, 1 more to go, and we are officially done with Cinnabar Island. It's time to leave. It's time to leave Cinnabar Island for good. It's time to head north. Along Route 21, and I get attacked. Tentacool, huh? Alright, so to get back to the mainland, we have to travel up this sea route, Route 21, but it's not gonna be easy. Because we'll probably get attacked every 10 seconds. And I'm not wasting any repel. Get out of my way. Now, like, this isn't so hard. All we have to do is really just go straight up. Like, it's just a straight path north to where we need to be. Oh, wow, got through those two guys. I might get out of here without having to fight a single trainer. Ah, so close to land. I'm surprised we haven't seen Tentacool's evolved form. Tentacruel. I'm really surprised we haven't seen one of those yet. Alright, we've made it home, and does this place look familiar? The music should sound familiar. That's right! Pallet Town. Shades of your journey await. That's right, we have made it back to where it all started. Pallet Town. Let's pay a visit to Mama. Matt, if you drive your Pokemon too hard, they'll dislike you. You should take a rest. Oh good, you and your Pokemon are looking great. Take care now. Well, thanks, I guess. Let's pay a visit to the Pokemon Lab. Yo, Professor Oak, guess who's back? Good to see you. How's your Pokedex coming? Here, let me take a look. Pokedex completion is 146 Pokemon seen, 143 Pokémon owned. Professor Oak's rating. I have nothing left to say. You're the authority now.
Wow.
Yeah, I think I explained this very early on in the LP, but if you talk to Professor Oak at any point in the game after getting your Pokédex, he'll actually rate your progress based on how deep into the game you are. And, yeah, that was a pretty complimentary thing he had to say to us. Like, what he says depends on, you know, how many Pokémon you have. Now, does this look familiar? Route 1, Pallet Town, Viridian City. And Viridian City, believe it or not, is our next destination. So let's go. And I get attacked. What else is new? Wow, Pidgey. It's been so long since I've been here. I remember back in, when I was recording for the second episode of this LP, and I was doing a level grind, I had to spend so much time in Route 1, trying to level grind. Okay, nothing to get in our way now. And I did not mean to read that sign. Alright, so check it out. Viridian City, the eternally green paradise. We have returned here to Viridian City to do one final thing. And what is this final thing we have to do, you may ask? Why, it's quite simple. Viridian City Pokémon Gym. That's right. Our journey has come full circle. It is soon going to be time for us to take on the final gym in this game and get our final Pokémon League badge. But you know what I'm going to say? You all are going to have to wait until the next episode for that. However, there is one thing we can do before we stop recording. Let's go over here and talk to this guy. Yawn. I must have dozed off in the sun. I had this dream about a drowsy eating my dream. What's this? Where did this TM come from? This is spooky. Here, you can have this TM. TM 42. TM 42 contains Dream Eater. And he falls asleep. I don't know if you want to fall asleep in the sun like that, dude. Try not to get sunburned. So yeah, get us an extra item. Not that we really need it. And, we are going to cut it here, ladies and gentlemen. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Pokémon Yellow for the Game Boy. We have defeated Blaine for the 7th Pokémon badge, which has allowed us to finish off Cinnabar Island for good. And we have now made the long journey back to Viridian City, which will be the site of the final Pokémon Gym. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you folks liked what you saw on this episode, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. And I will see all of you in the next episode of Let's Play Pokémon Yellow when we take on the final Pokémon Gym. See you then! Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it, and also don't forget to like me on Facebook!